You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services. Nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Hey, folks. I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it. There to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's a child of God, a husband, NRA conservative, radical right-wing supervillain, and Twitter rock star. American by birth, Texan by choice, and a badass by nature. He's the owner of TomOHalloran.com, OHalloranMedia.com, and PatriotRadio.net. Please welcome Tom O'Halloran.
And God bless you, America. Welcome to the Patriot Radio Show on a Friday morning. We generally do Jihad on America today, but yesterday I did not do a show, and we've just got a whole lot of stuff to cover. I've invited my good friend Bill Perryman, my usual Thursday morning co-host, to join me today instead. I was at the hospital with a dear friend of mine that I've mentioned over the last couple of weeks. And so we're just going to do yesterday's show today with today's news, of course. How long, you ask, until Obama leaves office? Well, 34 days, 13 hours, 57 minutes, and 30 seconds. Make that 29 seconds. Make that 28, 27, 26. I can do this for the whole show. This would be an easy show. Anyway, welcome to the Patriot Radio Show. I'm your host, Tom O'Halloran. And yes, I'm broadcasting today from my underground bunker deep in Arkansas, Nebraska, Colorado. We're here to educate, irritate, and agitate. And folks, we have a full helping of agitation on Slate today. Again, my name is Tom O'Halloran. My primary blog, TomO'Halloran.com. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/Patriot Radio Show. Personally, I'm at facebook.com/O'Halloran. And we do this show five times a week. Today is show number 454. Tune in at 9 a.m. Texas time, Monday through Thursday, for the Patriot Radio Show. Most Fridays, I do Jihad on America. Here I cover the Islamists in America, sharing with you who they are, what they want, and why you should be afraid. If you did not catch my show on the Muslim Brotherhood, my show on Islamophobia, or my show on Islam is not a religion, then please find your way to PatriotRadioShow.com. Listen to all three of these shows. They will give you insight and perspective on the Islamic topic that you've probably not heard elsewhere. They'll also give you a solid foundation upon which we build each and every Friday as we continue to pull back the mask of Islam, looking at what's being done in the name of Allah, both here and abroad. And we do the news about Islam around the world because it's a glimpse into the future of what's in store for us if we continue to allow the cancer of Islam to spread here in the homeland. Keep abreast of my shows, listen to the live stream, as well as catch up on the archives of any shows you may have missed, all at PatriotRadioShow.com. This show is rebroadcast daily at ConfederateBroadcasting.com, ConservativeRadioNetwork.com, at the Liberty Works Radio Network, and at RedNationRising.us. You can also take the show on the road with you, with your iPhone or Android, by downloading the TuneIn app and doing a search for The Patriot Radio Show. A little public service announcement for me, ahead of the show. I am looking for a new handgun, particularly if you are located in Texas. I'm looking for a .45, a 1911, either a Springfield Armory, a Colt, a Kimber, Sig Sauer. I'm not real particular on the maker of the gun, as long as it's a 1911 and it's in a .45. If you have one of these that you have available at a reasonable price, then please reach out to me on Facebook or by my phone. You've got my number. It's 903-445-8281. And let me know what you got, what you want for it. I'm currently in the market. With that, we're going to go straight to the phone. Bring in Bill Perryman. Bill, are you with me, brother?
Yeah, I am, Tom. And if you ever get a chance to shoot a Ruger .290, you might change your mind on the 1911 frame.
A .290. I'll check it out. I'll look for it. Ruger. I'm going to write that down so I don't forget it. Ruger .290. I like Ruger. I had an LCP, a little .38 revolver, that I was pretty happy with, except for the fact that it was a LCP, the lightweight. It's all mostly polymer. Ruger .290.
P290. Yes, all.
Okay, gotcha. I'll check it out. Anyway, welcome to the show. Sorry we missed you yesterday, but the friend in the hospital trumps big news to talk about on air, so you got to be there. We're going to start the show today, brother, the way you know we both love starting the show, with the good guy with the gun segment. Good guy with a gun. Got to love him. Business owner turns the tables on a robber who now faces charges in Shreveport, Louisiana, just a little bit east of you. A Shreveport man will be going to jail as quick as he gets out of the hospital. 36-year-old Michael Kelly of the 600 block of Springfield Avenue was taken to University Health for treatment of multiple gunshots early Tuesday afternoon. Kelly, a black burglar, once he's released from the hospital, Police Corporal Marcus Hines said he'll be booked into Shreveport City Jail on one count each of armed robbery, being a convicted felon in possession of a firearm and resisting an officer. He also has an outstanding warrant charging him with driving with no license. Ooh, there's a crime. Ooh. Kelly was taken to the hospital after the man tried to rob West Shreveport business and fired a gun at the owner. The gunman missed and instead was wounded himself. 71-year-old shop owner was working inside his shop when the man entered his business and asked to use the restroom. When the visitor exited the restroom, he withdrew a handgun and beat the owner and robbed him of his wallet. The owner, whose name has not been released, managed to fight off the attacker. The gunman began firing shots at the owner as he retreated. The owner got his own gun, shot at the robber, striking him 3 times. The wounded man outside the store collapsed in the roadway in front of the business. Detectives believe someone in a gold SUV then tried to retrieve the wounded man, but drove off before the police arrived. Now the authorities are trying to identify and locate the vehicle. His accomplices apparently got away. So that's one. I got another story because it's local, down the road a little ways from where I'm at. Northwest homeowner was left. This is in Arkansas, Nebraska, Colorado. Was left with a gunshot wound after a shootout with the would-be robbers. So this is the homeowner that's got a wound. Deputies said they are searching for the men who did walked up to the driveway and drew their guns. The investigator said the man tried to rob the homeowner in his garage, but the homeowner fought back. What the suspects did not know was that the homeowner had his gun nearby. During the alleged robbery attempt, the homeowner was shot in the back by the suspects, but the victim managed to pull out his gun and fire back. He may have hit one of the would-be robbers, but either way, the attack ended as the victim opened fire. Suspects ran off and haven't been seen since. Deputies have been searching backyards of neighboring homes to find the guy. So far, they've not been found. I really hate hearing of homeowners firing and missing. Responsible gun owners, we've gone over this earlier in the week, I believe when Mike Nelson was on. If you're going to have a gun for defense, learn how to use it. Learn how to hit the bad guys you're shooting at. Elsewise, your bullets are going to go across the street and possibly do harm to an innocent bystander. So, how you been, brother?
I've been doing pretty good. And I'd like to touch on something we talked about this morning, good guys with the gun. And that's about, there's about 4 little net news site guys, groups, and they're going around teaching all the security, law enforcement, just a whole bunch of people about the new open carry law, and there's also been a new law passed about filming government property from public areas.
Yes, which is legal. Which is absolutely legal.
And they're having to bring this to their attention because evidently 80% of our law enforcement and security companies do not know this.
Either they don't know it or they want to ignore it and try to chase people away that are doing something that is perfectly legal. So, yes. Yeah, there are a lot of videos online. I've watched probably close to 100 of people open carrying sometimes a long gun over their shoulder walking down the streets. The citizens will call and complain. The police will come out. And the police will try to tell the armed man that he can't do that. Well, if you're doing it, you'd better know the law and stand up to the police by reciting the law to them and demanding that they get their superiors out there, somebody that actually knows the law, and inform these people that this is legal, that it is proper, and you've got to know the law. Because in Texas, open carry, whether it's a long gun or now a handgun on your hip, it's perfectly legal. But you've got to know the rules. You've got to know the law. And you've got to be clean. You can't go out and do that if you've got 15 warrants or you're a felon with a gun.
Yeah.
So you've got to know the law. You've got to obey the law. And if you're going to do this and draw attention to yourself, just make sure you're clean. Because once they stop you, and they will run your name if you give it to them, you're not obligated to because you haven't committed a crime. They have no reason to suspect you of a crime. But if you're going to give your name to the police, you'd better be clean. I've seen guys standing up trying to show off that they know the law and they can carry an open gun. They run their name and they got an open warrant for an armed robbery or something in another state. These guys are idiots.
I found these very educational videos. I learned things I did not know.
Yep.
And I'm sure there are many people that don't know these laws. And God bless these men for having the courage to go out there and do this stuff. Some of them are rather confrontational. They like the confrontation because it makes YouTube video hits.
Right.
But basically, it is explaining to the police the new laws that we have.
Yep. And no matter where you're at, because new laws are here in Texas, but the laws everywhere exist, and a lot of times the police are not aware of them, or they're hoping you're not aware of them. Even a police stop, you're not required to give your name and identification to the police unless they can tell you why they suspect that you may have committed a crime and what the crime is.
And yes, if you're being detained, you have to give them ID. But if they cannot say that you're being detained, you don't have to tell them anything.
Right. And I love watching these videos. I've watched literally hundreds of these police stop videos. And when the police are demanding an ID from somebody and they're refusing to give ID and the police know that they can't force the issue, sometimes the police don't realize that. And, you know, they drag somebody out of the car and stuff, and sometimes you go to court. So when you go down this road, just know that because the cop is insisting, doesn't give him the right to drag you out of the car, but he may do it anyway. So you may win this case in court. You may win a lawsuit. You may win money. You may just get an apology. But in the meantime, you may end up spending a few days in jail. So before you go and do this, ask yourself, how committed are you? Because you come across a jerk cop, and there are jerk cops out there, you may end up doing jail time before, and it may cost you a lot of money, because lawyers are free. They've got to provide you a lawyer if you don't have the money. But the lawyer you're going to get for free works for the very people that are stopping you. And they're not going to really work very hard to get you acquitted or charges dropped. So be aware of what's going on and what you're looking to do. But go watch some of these police stop videos, these open carry videos. It's a wealth of information that's free. It's entertaining for sure. But it's also very, very informative. And you were mentioning one on Shell. Tell me about the Shell thing.
Let's see, these are Deer Park, the Shell and Deer Park.
And Deer Park is southeast Houston.
Yes, it is. And for about three times they went out there, they called them initiations. They go out there and they initiate these people to what is the law and what they can do. And the first confrontation can be pretty rough, but they got through it. So they went out there a second time, and the guys would not even leave their vehicles. They just cruised around in their vehicles and looked at them. But they sent a woman out there by herself. These guys flew out of their vehicles and, you know, they accosted her. They even, seriously, the road speed out there at one point on this one side road is 55 miles an hour. Cars just flying by. And this guy was literally crowding her into the road.
Wow.
That's how all the, you know, and so I think, you know, security guards are probably the worst because they've got a little badge and they think they've got some power and most of them seem to want to abuse it.
And they're typically people that couldn't get into the police force, so they've got a grudge.
Yeah.
Or they've been cops, but they've been drummed out of the police departments because of their abuse of people or something. So, yeah, security guards are oftentimes suffering from a little Napoleonic complex. So I'm gonna look for the shell stuff, because that when they start pushing people into traffic or forcing people into an area, I've seen that too. When the cops tell you to get back, you can't stand here, you got to stand over there. Then you stand over where they tell you to stand, and I've seen them actually arrest them for being on private property after being told that's where they can stand. I've seen that.
Oh, exactly. Tell them that the sidewalk is their property.
Yeah.
Of course, now, there is no sidewalk in any city or any place that is not public property.
Yeah.
That's why they're sidewalks.
Exactly.
And they're forcing them off the sidewalks into the street and then arresting them for obstructing traffic.
Yeah, all sorts of tricky stuff. But police stop videos are incredibly interesting to watch, even border crossing stops, where you're trying to cross the border coming into the United States or crossing from one state to another state, and the Border Patrol is stopping you and asking for ID, asking if you're a citizen. You don't have to answer that. And most people would, because who wants to be detained or who wants to be a jerk or whatever. But when these people just refuse to do it, and in time after time, after being stalled and arguing with them, they're just told you're free to go. They win. Almost always. Every once in a while, you'll see some Border Patrol agent or cop that'll just go crazy and bust a window out and drag the people out of the car. And you know there's a lawsuit. Somebody's gonna get a brand new car out of it. But
Well, a window anyway.
What's that?
A window anyway.
Well, definitely the window. But when they drag you out of the car, I mean, they're violating your rights. When you haven't done anything, when you've explained to them that they don't have a right to force you to show an ID, you explain your rights, your constitutional rights, and they ignore that. Then when they do this physical thing with you, they are then violating your civil rights, and that's like treble damages. They really go after the police when you sue the city after they violated you, when you've pointed out that they're not acting lawfully and they still do it. The penalties are pretty severe. So people, you know, if you're willing to pay the price, the time in jail and the lengthy lawsuits and stuff, people come away from those with some pretty good coinage. So watch the videos. I'm going to go check out the shell ones today, because that's a little extra dangerous when you have private security guards acting like cops and doing these nasty things. And I understand that they're really the bullies on women. They're not so much doing this to the men. They'll have sit in their cars and watch the men do what they're doing. But when a smaller person or a woman comes along, they'll get out and they'll be a bully and start pushing them around and stuff. So, brother, we're going to take a quick break and we're going to come back and start the actual show part of the show. All right?
Greetings.
Folks, stick around. It is the Patriot Radio Show, even though it's Friday. Please, stick around. We got a lot coming up. We're going to do in the next block, we're going to do a lot of stuff on the Trump appointees. Doing some comparisons between who he's appointed and who was appointed by Obama. And we touched on this a little bit yesterday. We got some new names for you today. And I want to reinforce some of the stats between Obama and Reagan. So stick around. We'll be right back.
Winston tastes good like a cigarette should. Winston tastes good like a cigarette should. Winston gives you real flavor for rich tobacco flavor. Winston's easy drawing too. The filter lets the flavor through. Winston tastes good like a cigarette should.
Folks, the biggest show in town is opening tomorrow at your Nash dealers. Now, you may think you've seen everything, but wait until you see your first new Nash 600. Sure, it's beautiful, but it's not just a new model. It's a new kind of car. So new, so different, you'll just have to see it to believe it. Think of it, 25 to 30 miles on a gallon of gasoline at moderate highway speed. And it's big. Plenty of headroom, leg room, and elbow room for six large people to lounge at ease. And it has a weather-eye conditioned air system and a convertible bed, coil springing on all four wheels. But words can't describe the new Nash cars. You've just got to see them to appreciate them. They're terrific performers, and so much smoother, so much quieter, so much easier to drive. But don't let other folks try to tell you what they're like. See the new Nash 600 and the Nash Ambassador yourself tomorrow at your Nash dealers. They're there right now waiting for you. One look, and you'll know why we say you'll be ahead with Nash.
Well, Oscar Otto, the loquacious limousine, and in top form.
Sure, Arlo, and it's because I'm equipped with an Autolite electrical system.
Ah, then you must have an Autolite starting motor, generator, battery, coil distributor, and a set of Autolite spark plugs, plus all the other important parts that go to make up the complete Autolite electrical system used as original equipment on many leading makes of our finest cars, trucks, and tractors. That means every unit and component part of your Autolite electrical system is related by Autolite engineering design and manufacturing skill to give the smoothest performance money can buy.
That's why my owner always insists on Autolite original factory parts.
And friends, you'll find it pays to insist on Autolite original factory parts for your Autolite equipped car. Because from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite.
Never borrow money needlessly, just when you must. Borrow them where loans are especially from folks you trust. Borrow confidently from HFC.
Household Finance Corporation offices are listed in your telephone book.
Mr. Clean gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute.
Mr. Clean will clean your whole house and everything that's in it.
Floors, doors, walls, halls, white sidewall tires, and old golf balls.
Sinks, stoves, bathtubs, he'll do. He'll even help clean laundry, too.
Mr. Clean gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute.
Mr. Clean will clean your whole house and everything that's in it.
Can he clean a kitchen sink?
Quicker than a wink.
Can he clean a window sash?
Faster than a flash.
Can he clean a dirty mirror?
He'll make it bright and clearer.
Can he clean a diamond ring?
Mr. Clean cleans anything.
Mr. Clean gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute. Mr. Clean will clean your whole house and everything that's in it. Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean.
Budweiser commercial featuring the crew cut.
Where there's life, there's fun. At a concert or a show, in your own backyard, wherever you go, Budweiser beer is for folks to know. Where there's life, there's fun. Budweiser.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we
And we are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Friday morning. We have on the phone my good friend Bill Perryman. I want to talk about the appointments that Trump's been making. We touched on it yesterday with, or not yesterday, Wednesday with with Jen Hamem on the air. But I've been very, very pleased with his picks overall. What do you think?
I like them almost every single one, especially David Friedman for Ambassador to Israel. That's awesome.
That was great, yeah. Yeah, love that one.
But Ryan Zink, Interior Secretary, this guy is a big government dude, I'm afraid. I mean, the only thing I really know is he wants to keep public lands under federal ownership. And I'm kind of for state rights there.
Yeah, you and me both. But bear in mind, it's not what he likes, but what Trump likes. If he's going to be the
exactly.
man, he's going to carry out exactly. Trump's objectives are what matter here, and I believe Trump is for paring them back and giving the land back to the states. But this guy is supportive of energy. He'll back drilling virtually anywhere. So
yes.
I like that. I like the fact that he's a former Navy SEAL. He was He was a SEAL commander for about 24 years, I believe. So I like him a lot. He's one of several top military officers that Trump's picked. Jen had an issue the other day about Tillerman, the Exxon chief, being the guy in charge of Secretary of State. What are your thoughts there?
Tillerman, I am, you know, I really, really, I'm looking him up right now.
Okay.
And
while you do that, I'll give you a minute, because I kind of sandbagged you with that. I didn't intend to, but Tillerman's the CEO of Exxon. And I love Jen to death. Her thoughts on it were like my initial thought. Why in the hell would we pick a head guy of an oil company to be Secretary of State? What the heck does he know about that? But this guy does contracts. As the head of the Exxon Corporation, he works out contracts with all of the countries that we're going to be dealing with as Secretary of State. Every country over there in the desert, with China, with Brazil, every oil-producing company, he's already doing contracts with these people. Now, you don't, as a CEO, you don't go sit down and work out a contract with Iran or with Saudi Arabia or any one of these countries and come back to your board of directors and say, well, I went over there, but they basically bent me over and had their way with me, and we're going to be making a lot less money this year than we did last year. No, you don't last. You don't last to your second meeting if this happens. So this guy, A, knows all the players. B, he's a top negotiator.
Oh, yeah.
He's a tough guy, and he has the respect of the mullahs over there, which is who you're going to be talking to as a Secretary of State. So on that,
well, he's done business all around the world. He's respected around the world because he's done business in every country.
Exactly. So he knows the players. He's a top negotiator, and as opposed to Hillary or John Kerry, who. As Secretary of State, they go over there and work out contracts and basically give whoever they're negotiating with everything that they're asking for and get nothing in return, like they did with Russia. Well, yeah, we'll take down all of our missile defense systems. We'll deactivate all of our nuclear arms. We'll do all of this stuff. What will you do? Oh, nothing? Well, okay.
Here's 20% of our uranium.
Yeah, right? So, this doesn't happen. Now, an interesting analysis between Trump's cabinet, Obama's cabinet, and let's go back to Ronald Reagan's cabinet. Okay?
Sure.
Obama's cabinet, his appointees, had an average of 17 years in academia or government. So he had all these theoretical people, all these professional thinkers with 17 years of experience. He had a total of zero. A total of zero top business people in his cabinet. Now let's go back to Ronald Reagan. 6.9 years of government experience on average. He had four top CEOs, or CEOs are top business people. Trump has six CEOs. Obama, zero. So do you want thinkers, do you want government appointees who fail at one job and get moved around to a different department, like Lois Lerner, who is head of the IRS's division that kind of snooped on all conservatives, who had failed at five other departments before she was moved into that position? Or do you want somebody who has worked their way from one successful job to a bigger successful job to a bigger successful job? People with a track record of success.
And am I wrong? Did not Reagan have Henry Kissinger? Didn't he?
Yes.
Well, there was a little surprise pick for me today. I find it pleasing. It's K.T. McFarland,
yes,
who was an aide to Henry Kissinger, is now our national deputy national secretary advisor, security advisor.
And appointed along with that, working with K.T. McFarland, will be Monica Crowley.
Yeah.
She just got appointed as the another deputy national security advisor. So those two together, who had both worked in the Reagan administration, and they'll be working. Yeah. They'll be working under Lieutenant Michael Flynn, Lieutenant General Michael Flynn. So Obama, Trump now has five top military officers, four generals, and an admiral.
Yes.
Plus six CEOs. Talk about a leadership powerhouse. I mean, this is just absolute home runs. Home runs. The only one he's got that I'm not real thrilled with is Treasury. He pulled another Goldman Sachs guy for Treasury.
Yeah.
But again, he's picked the. I'm not sure whether he's a CEO or whether he's a president or even a VP at Goldman Sachs. But again, it's not a professor. It's not a government hack that has failed. You don't get to his position without having knowledge of the industry and without having respect of the industry. So, while it's not my preference, you can't just pull somebody out of business or out of academia and expect them to do a good job. So, I'm going to give Trump this one. Because, A, I don't have anybody better to pick, and, B, he's done such a great job on the others, I have to believe that he knows what he's doing with this guy. Okay? Now, one that we talked about the other day, which I'm going to ask you for your comments on, because he's from Texas, Secretary of Energy, Rick Perry.
Drill, baby, drill.
I love this on so many levels. On so many levels. A, he's a Texan. You got to love your home state picks. B,
oh, yeah.
B, he's on the board of Energy Transfer Corporation, who is the company putting the pipeline through the Dakotas, who Obama has promised to stop. Now we're putting a guy in charge of energy who's promised to make those pipelines go through. And he actually has a vested stake in them going through. Of course, he'll be removed from the board for this job. But still, you know where his heart is. You're putting a man in charge of oil, an oil man in charge of energy. Obama had a whole house full of greenies around him. So we put all this money into Solyndra and 50-something other failed solar and companies trying to turn seaweed into oil.
Yeah.
Trump's got oil men in charge of energy. I freaking love that. This has the left pissing their pants.
Oh my God, they're going crazy. Along with the fact that Perry also has wanted to in the past eliminate the DOE, the Department of Energy.
Now to be fair, he was on the debate stage in 2011. And he said, there are three departments that I would do away with to cut the size of American government. The Department of Education, the Department of Labor, and I can't think of the other one. He couldn't even think. He couldn't even think of the name of the department that he is now going to be running. That is such an irony that I love it on those terms alone. I do think it would be a great department to eliminate, but I think it's going to be a long process. If Trump does 8 years, maybe we'll get all of this land turned land from the Interior Department turned over to the states. Turn over the drilling rights back over to the states. Let them determine these things. And I'd love to see Trump eliminate. I don't see it happening, really. Trump isn't really a smaller government guy. He talks some of that, but I think in his heart, you know, there's not a problem government can't solve. So I'm not really betting money on Trump eliminating any departments. But at least we're getting them into hands of people that are going to get the government under control. One of his absolute best picks is the head of the EPA. The EPA is one of the most dangerous organizations in government because you appoint a head of the EPA, and what you can't get pushed through Congress as laws, the president can enact through regulation. And the EPA has taken so much private land from individuals because they're putting in a lake, or they're harvesting rainwater, or they're damming a stream that goes through their property. They put businesses out of business with their regulations. And these regulations are written by bureaucrats, just appointed people, with no accountability to anybody. So who did he put in charge of the EPA? The Attorney General of the great state of Oklahoma. That's what we call North Texas.
Yeah.
This guy has been side by side with the state of Texas in suing the EPA over their out of control regulations.
Yes.
So this is an absolute out of the park home run when it comes to appointments. I've absolutely grown a man crush on Donald Trump over his appointments for his cabinet. Just one after the other, they're just absolute killer. You put a man in charge, you put a general that's a border hawk in charge of Homeland Security. You put a general in charge of the Department of Defense. Trump, I couldn't have appointed a better cabinet, and I've tried. I mean, you and I both, we've made our picks of who I'd like to see in charge of what departments. And he has picked my picks on a couple. He has picked better people than I have envisioned for several. And just absolute. He picked another one today. It was Lieutenant Keith Kellogg for National Security Council post. The Executive Secretary and Chief of Staff for the National Security Council. A couple other real quick ones here. We've got Interior Chief. That guy is the Zinke. I think he's going to be a great pick. We don't know for sure right now. Monica Crowley. We still don't have a defined press secretary. We're still seeing the hot lawyer from the Five. Who's the Italian gal that used to be married to the mayor, now governor, no, not governor, attorney general of California.
I know you're, I can't, oh Lord,
yeah,
I don't know.
She's being considered, as is, yeah, drawn blanks on both of them, but conservative columnist, And she's got her own show. Golly, I'm drawing brain farts today. Let's see if the chat room can come up with it. Who are we talking about on the Five? Anyway.
She's married to a governor.
Yeah.
And she's not bad. She's not unpleasing to look at either.
No, real easy on the eyes. But anyway, those two are being considered for press secretary and communications director. Then David Friedman for ambassador, and we will be moving our embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. I need to look into that. Guilfoyle, that's right. Kimberly Guilfoyle, and I'm trying to say Loretta. It's not Loretta. The blonde conservative mouthpiece. Not Ann Coulter, but the other one.
The one that wears a cross. Oh, man.
I'm sure she does. Got an L in her name. Not Loretta, but anyway, we'll get it during the break. We'll be right back. We got some more bills to pay, which we're not really paying our bills, folks. Monica Crowley is going into the State Department as the Deputy Security Advisor for foreign stuff, working with KT McFarland. But we'll get this other gal when we go to the break, folks. Stick around. We'll be right back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Friday. We're on air.
Laura Ingram.
Who?
Laura Ingram.
Laura Ingram. Thank you, brother. I told you it was an L. I had it. I nailed it. Almost. We'll be right back, folks. We're on air with my good buddy. What's his name? Bill Perry. His name starts with a B. It's a B. It's a B.
Everybody's talking Temple, the new filter cigarette.
Far more charcoal. Far more charcoal.
How does all that flavor get through all that charcoal in that new filter cigarette?
Temple. The secret's in the structure of Temple's all-new filter. Try the new filter cigarette, Temple.
Temple brings you far more activated charcoal than in previous filter designs. The first bonded charcoal filter. A new kind of filter for a taste too good to miss. Quite a strong filter, too. No health claim is made for Temple. Only the promise of easy draw, smoother taste.
How does all that flavor get through all that charcoal in that new filter cigarette?
Temple! The secret's in the structure of Temple's all-new filter. Try the new filter cigarette, Temple!
Waiter! Waiter! Bill, did you ever see such poor service? I'm going to call a manager.
Take it easy, Walt. What's mostly wrong is your grouch.
I'm sorry, Phil, but my digestion is so upset.
What you may need for your poor digestion is something that works after nature's own order. Try Carter's Little Liver Pills.
Good advice. When your digestion is upset and you feel headachy and irritable, take Carter's Little Liver Pills. You see, each day, nature normally produces about 2 pints of a vital digestive juice to help digest your food. If nature fails, your food may remain undigested, leaving you headachy and irritable. To feel cheerful and happy again, take Carter's Little Liver Pills. They increase the flow of this vital digestive juice quickly, often in as little as 30 minutes, and you're on the road to feeling better. Don't depend on artificial aids to counteract indigestion when Carter's Little Liver Pills aid digestion after nature's own order. Take Carter's Little Liver Pills as directed. Get them at any drugstore, only 25 cents.
Once upon a time there was an engineer.
Choo-choo Charlie was his name, we hear.
He had an engine and he sure had fun. He used good and plenty candy to make his train run.
Charlie says, love my good and plenty. Charlie says, really rings the bell. Charlie says, love my good and plenty. Don't know any other candy that I love so well.
Two beans times two beans is four beans.
Nescafe uses lots more beans.
10 beans times 4 beans, and add 3 more beans, make 43 rich coffee beans.
Yes, you get 43 beans in every cup of Nescafe, real coffee beans. That's all there is in Nescafe, 43 beans in every cup. Make Nescafe the all-coffee instant coffee. With the let's have another cup, hey.
Extra beans means extra flavor. Today's Nescafe goes all the way for flavor with 43 choice beans in every cup.
You worked too hard, you ate too much, the cheesecake made you greedy. Let your aching head and stomach hear this message from Old Speedy. Alka-Seltzer, plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Plop, plop, fizz, fizz. Oh, what a relief it is. Ah, those speedy Alka-Seltzer bubbles burst into action to relieve your upset stomach and aching head fast. Use only as directed. Oh, what a relief it is. What a relief.
Pepsi Cola hits the spot. 12 full ounces, that's a lot. Twice as much for a nickel, too. Pepsi Cola is the drink for you.
Tom O'Halloran, holding the line against tyranny from Washington, D.C.
I am America, one voice, united we stand. I am America, one hope to heal our land. There is still work that must be done. I will not rest until we won.
And we are back. It's the Patriot Radio Show on a Friday. We're on the air with my good friend, Bill Perriman. Bill, out of Texas, a judge just reversed an order against a school. The school was banning a sign for a Christmas play. The sign had on it a Charlie Brown Christmas. It said on the sign, "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." That is what Christmas is about, Charlie Brown. The school banned the sign. The school board banned the sign. Somebody sued the city. The judge supported the ban, and an appeals judge overturned that. This overturn was backed by Attorney General of Texas Ken Paxton. We have here in Texas, passed just 3 years ago, the Merry Christmas Bill, which allows schools to support Christmas and Hanukkah. So students and teachers can say Merry Christmas and put up Christmas trees. We're not going to be bullied by these leftist organizations like a lot of states are. And this one had to go to court to be overthrown. But it's nice to see that the Christians are winning here in the great state of Arkansas-Nebraska-Rado.
Yes, it is. And it's one of my pet peeves is folks need, especially conservatives, need to get on these school boards so we can get our children back.
Absolutely. And folks, whenever you hear somebody say separation of church and state, stop them and make them show you where that is written. That is not in the Constitution. It is not in any of the amendments. It is not in the Declaration of Independence. The term is made up by the liberals. The Second Amendment, the First Amendment states that the government shall create no religion. Okay? The First Amendment guarantees us the freedom of speech. It gives us the freedom of religion. It stops the Congress from issuing laws declaring a given religion. So the First Amendment does not, as opposed to what they'll have you believe, it does not prevent schools from putting up a Christmas tree. It does not stop a school from praying. There's no such thing as freedom from speech. The Constitution prohibits actions by Congress, not by schools. Prohibits Congress from creating a state-sponsored religion. That's all it does. There is nothing in the world preventing a school from praying. Nothing. And it pisses me off when the left... Well, that doesn't piss me off. It annoys me when the left tries to stop a school from praying or putting up the Ten Commandments on a courthouse. That bothers me that the left tries that. It pisses me off to see conservatives, to see Republicans caving to this, because it shows the ignorance of the Constitution. There is nothing prohibiting a county or a state from putting the Ten Commandments on the courthouse lawn or on the wall of a courthouse. Your thoughts?
Well, exactly that there is no law demanding that. There's the God and the Lord is mentioned in many of our founding documents, and especially throughout the Federalist Papers, a lot of that is explained in the way to keep it separated, but not separated from the people, separated from the government forcing it on the people.
Exactly. And that's why there was a big problem, why we came here and tried to do a different type of government than what they had over in Europe, where the king decided what the religion was, and if you weren't of that, you could be persecuted. Here, everybody has a right to practice their chosen religion. The only thing the Constitution constrains is government. It does not constrain people. So, stop the left when you hear them talking about separation of church and state. Every state in the United States, every state in the Union, 50 out of 50, which is nearly all of them, every one of them has a constitution, and in every one of the constitutions, it mentions God.
Yes, it does.
Not Christ, God, which is open to your interpretation.
And before 1963, I forget the year, but our Supreme Court said that there would be no better guide for students to learn by than the Bible. Yep. It is a perfect teaching book.
Absolutely.
Yet in 1963, under total liberal Supreme Court, they've thrown the Bible out of schools, and we have gone downhill fast,
which is why we need to come back to the states and let the states run their affairs. Because if you look at 1963, you look at how far down our education has slipped since we took God out of the schools, and you'll begin to find a correlation. So we need to bring it back to the states. And for the record, the Constitution does not say that Texas cannot create a state religion, that Christianity is the only religion that will be allowed in the state, because that is a state that would be making that law. The Constitution only determines what Congress can do. So as the great state of Texas, we can do these things. Oklahoma can say we are going to be the state of Jews. Only Jews will be allowed in this state. Now, you may see an uprising, but the point is the Constitution does not prohibit states or people within the states or school districts from doing a damn thing. So when you hear people quoting the Constitution, call them on it. Show that you're smart enough to know the difference. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Trump team is reviewing options for Obama's executive orders in the first 100 days. We're going to see a record number of executive orders fed into a shredder. I hope they do that. I hope they actually put them in a shredder in a press conference. It will be a long press conference, but it'll be an interesting one. report, FBI Director Comey tells Trump there is no evidence that the Russians swayed the election. It is fake news coming out of the left. Exclusive. Oh, yeah. FBI New York field office is ordered to go forward on the Clinton Foundation probe. This is happening. Breaking. Attorney General Lynch. Obama cannot give a pardon to the Dreamers en masse.
No.
We touched on this last week. If he wants to pardon the Dreamers from any crimes, he's got to do them individually. And how many can he actually do in 34 days?
So, yeah.
A registered sex offender arrested in Virginia, Leonard Kidd, was hired by Petco to play Santa. A sex offender sitting there taking pictures with kids on his lap. What the hell is Petco thinking? They don't do background checks anymore? Folks, that's the show for today. Brother, I appreciate you taking the time out of your hectic schedule to come on and do this show for me today. I know you didn't get an invite till about 2 a.m., but I appreciate you, man, more than you can know. God bless you.
No problem.
God bless you and yours, America. This is Tom O'Halloran. O'Halloran? O'Halloran. And Bill Perryman. We are so out of here. Shout out.
Happy Christmas.
Right. Absolutely. Merry Christmas to everybody, although we'll be seeing you. Come Monday, I'll announce the holiday schedule. We'll be taking some days off. We're going to do a little bit of traveling over the holidays. Carol Pillow in the chat room. Mike wasn't in today, but love you, girl. Thank you for being there. And have a blessed weekend. We're out of here, folks. Bye.